Unity provides many ways to rotate a game object. Here's 12. Use transform.rotate to rotate a game object by Euler angles in degrees specified by vector 3. The rotate around function can be used to rotate along a specified axis by a certain amount of degrees. You can also specify the point in which you want to rotate around. Transform.EulerAngles sets an object's rotation directly to a specified angle in degrees. This represents an absolute orientation, where transform.rotate applies a relative rotation. Keep in mind that specifying Euler angles can have some strange behavior, like gimbal lock. Transform.localEulerAngles sets the object's local rotation as opposed to its world orientation. This has the same limitations with clamping, so keep that in mind. With a first guess, we might think that adding angles together is the right approach. However, quaternions use multiplication to combine rotations by performing a complex set of mathematical operations. This multiplication adheres to the rule of quaternion algebra, ensuring that the resultant orientation is accurate and free from issues like gimbal lock. Transform.rotation is similar to transform.EulerAngles, as it specifies an absolute rotation. This uses a quaternion to specify the angles instead of Euler angles. The issue with clamping or gimbal lock goes away when using this method, as quaternions use four numbers to represent the rotation instead of just three. Unity provides some helper functions to specify rotations with a purpose. The quaternion look rotation function in Unity calculates a rotation such that the forward direction of the object aligns with the specified forward vector. We can use this to make one object look at another. This function can also take an upward vector in case you don't want your object to be upside down. Transform.lookAt provides a similar functionality to quaternion's look rotation. This function can easily point the forward direction to any point in space and can optionally specify an up vector. Quaternion.rotateTowards is used to smoothly rotate an object from its current rotation towards a target orientation. It takes a current rotation, a target rotation, and a maximum rotation angle that can be applied per call. If the maximum rotation angle is too small, you can get some strange behavior like this. Let's change the rotation of the object by using Rigidbody's functionality. We can specify a torque around an axis to create a rotation. You'll need to have some angular drag or this will run away. We can also specify a change in rotation directly with the Rigidbody. We can use rigidbody.moveRotation in order to make it play nicely with the other objects that are using physics in the game. Finally, we can combine any of these methods by applying one rotation to a parent object and different rotations to all the child objects. This can make for some really interesting behavior. Here's a tiny system made by nesting objects with their own rotations. Well, that's only 12 ways to rotate a game object, and I'm sure there's many more. If you can think of other rotations I've missed, leave it in the comments below. See you next time!